Hello, congrats on buying your Warhammer Quest Lost Relics box set. This box contains everything you need to play, but did you know that the fun doesn't stop there? In this video, we'll be showing you how to bring your game to life by painting your miniatures. Painting your models is great fun, and by following this guide, you'll be able to get your miniatures on the table in no time at all. All the paints needed for this tutorial are on screen now, and we won't need many to get your Lost Relics miniatures looking great. We've chosen our paints to match the colour scheme shown on the box art, but you can paint your miniatures however you like. So the first thing we're going to do is apply Retributor armour all over the miniature. Now this may seem a little strange, but this is called undercoating, and we do this because it gives the rest of our paints something to stick to. So we're going to apply multiple layers until the whole model is covered and there's no more bare plastic showing through. It's always a good idea to add a touch of water to all your paints and apply them to the miniature in a couple of thin layers. This gives us a super smooth finish. Once that's dry, we're going to move on to applying lead belcher to any silver details. So you can see that these paints have metallic flakes in them, and these flakes can transfer to your water pot when you've washed off your brush. So we advise changing your water to stop it making your other paints shiny. So next we're going to move on to applying Cantor Blue on any blue areas. So this is things like the robes. If you're ever not sure which areas to pick out in certain colours, you can use the box art as a guide, or just feel free to paint it however you like. And we're using a small base brush for this, as it's small enough to keep things neat, but big enough to allow us to paint quickly. With the blue done, we're moving on to Rakarth Flesh, and we'll be applying this onto the face, tabard, and the rocks. We've chosen this as it matches the box art, but you can use whatever colours you want. Next, we're going to pick out the white areas with Corax White. This is quite a thick paint, so do make sure you thin it down with a little bit of water. We'll be using this to paint the inside of the tabard, the beard, and the spikes. With all that done, we're moving on to Abaddon Black for any black areas. So this is things like the gloves and a few straps here and there. Try and be as neat as you can, as it does provide a better end result, but don't worry if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with the previous colours. And our final base paint is Rhinox Hide, and we're using this to pick out the brown areas and also the base. And with all our base coats applied, there's nothing stopping you cracking on with the game right now. But if you'd like to take your paint job up a notch, stick with us for a super easy way to do so. Just remember to leave your paints to dry fully before moving on to the next step. This will take around 30 minutes. If you're waiting around, you could even make a start on another miniature. In the next section of this guide, we'll be using shade paints. These are very thin paints designed to seep into the recessed details of the miniatures and darken them to create depth. We apply shades over base coats because they can't grip onto unpainted plastic. They'll just slide off. The first shade we're going to use is Reichland Flesh Shade, and we'll be applying this all over the gold areas. You can see that the paint's really thin, so just make sure not to overload your brush. If you do find this happening, just clean off your brush and use the bristles to soak up any excess paint. This is the ideal shade to go over gold, as it creates a deep and rich tone. Next, we're going to use Agrax Earthshade and apply this over any brown details, the base, tabard, and also the face. Agrax Earthshade is a great all-round shade that works over many base coats, giving a nice dark brown shade in the recesses. And our final shade is Norn Oil. We'll be applying this onto the cloak, beard, and any silver details. Norn Oil is another shade that works well over a variety of base coats, and it's really up to you which shades you choose. We've chosen this one over these areas to really darken the colours and add some strong depth to those recesses. And now the last thing we need to do is paint the rim of the base. This is a great finishing touch for all your miniatures, and for this, we've used Rhinox Hide just to tie everything together. So as before, add a touch of water to the paint and apply several layers to get a nice consistent finish. Congratulations, your Warhammer Quest Lost Relics miniatures are painted and ready for battle. If this has inspired you to learn more about painting miniatures, you can find loads of helpful information over on citadelcolour.com. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video and we hope you have great fun painting your own miniatures. Bye!